Okay, hey guys, I know I'm in a wide angle lens, so this stance probably isn't necessary, but hi, how are we doing? I'm Amy from Different Dance, and I'm so excited to finally be dancing with people and not just with the odd arrangement of boxes in my back bedroom. I'm so grateful also to be stranded in Cape Breton with a little more space and some family around versus the very small area of space I would have in my apartment in Toronto. So, while these aren't the best of circumstances, and clearly I'm just filming from my iPhone, I even left my tripod in Toronto, so we're dealing with some weird difficulties, but we're gonna make it work. So please bear with me. We are going to do a really nice feeling combo today. It doesn't move too much, but if you need to alter anything because you don't have a whole lot of space, please feel free to do so. Get creative. We want to see your interpretation of what we're doing, and feel free to involve family, friends, pets, whatever you're feeling in the moment. And yeah, just always a reminder to warm up beforehand. We'll do a really short warm up, always starting with cardio, moving on to a little bit of abs and stretching as well. In the next few days, at least for the different page, we're gonna start to post our ab workouts, so the plank to the Louvre by Lorde, and as well as the crunch exercise to Willing and Able by Disclosure. We're gonna have both of those up on our page. I know some of you who know them would probably rather forget them, but it's nice to have them just in case we need something to motivate us. As well as we might throw up a stretching regimen and some more cardio work. But for now, I'm just gonna play a jam and we're gonna get moving.
Hi everybody. So the portion of the song we're using Hurt by Johnny Cash. If you want to see another rendition of the video, you can always check out my Instagram page, so at Amy Rahe. The very last video that I posted was a not the highest of quality videos, but it was from a class where I've taught this. So if you want to take another peek at this combo in a different format, please feel free to take a look at that. It's virtually the exact same. Not much has changed since. So we're going to be doing about the last minute-ish of Hurt by Johnny Cash. If you can find it on YouTube or Spotify, truly anywhere, that's the portion we'll be using. Depending on which version you're using, whether it be YouTube or Spotify, it might start at a different section, but I'm going to play it just once for you now, and I want you to just listen to the song. Truly, I think that knowing our music is something very important in dance. Being able to listen to it and feel what comes up in our bodies and what comes up in our hearts and our minds when we just take in not even just the lyrics, but the tone of the music, different instruments at play, how they change, the tempo, and how can we match our textures and the feelings in our physical self, not just this, but in our full body, to match what the artist is trying to say. So I invite you to listen to that portion of the song that we'll be dancing to. I'll play it right now so you can kind of get a hold of where we'll be starting and what we'll be doing before we jump into some choreography. So here it comes.
I'm still right here. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have.
Song we'll be dancing to. We are not dancing all the way to the end, but I invite you to, of course, improv once the combo is finished. It starts at around 2:22 if you're using the Spotify version. So let's get started. Also, sorry if I look a mess. I've only brought a couple of items home with me. Unfortunately, I packed lightly thinking I was going to run an event in Newfoundland and run right back to Toronto, and boy, was I mistaken. So pardon my appearance, but let's get to it. So we are going to start, of course, in a nice hip-width parallel stance, a classic, love it. So if you're overestimating your hip stance, this is how you know. You're going to bring your hands to your hip bones right here. You're gonna look down. Are your toes right underneath there? Are your heels right underneath there? If so, good job. If they're wider, bring it on in. If they're closer together, of course, space them out. So we want our toes and our heels in alignment. We're in a parallel stance, and we wanna have a little bit of a plie so we can easily move about. as we do. We're going to start on the five. Our chest is going to be lifted, our chin is going to be proud, and we're going to be presenting our energy slightly up. We're holding one, two, three, four. Arms are just hanging by the sides, but with some strength. We then bring the head down, five, six, seven, eight. As we bring the head down, as you can see, we're going to be shifting our weight from the heels into the balls of the feet, almost to the point of falling, but catching ourselves before we do so. So we have one, two, three, four. We're going to move the head, shift the feet, or shift the weight, five, six, seven, eight, almost going over. From here, you're going to set the right foot out on one. As you do, you're going to lead with the heel. So it's going to be quite a deeper step and a heavier step than normal. Our hands are going to opposition us, and we're going to bring the left hand in front in a blade, right hand behind in a blade, with the elbows out and wide. And we're going to hit a little lift with the shoulders, a little lift with the shoulders, including the chest as well. So after we have our lean, five, six, seven, eight, we are then going to become proud again, just at a lower level, one, two. So we're allowing ourselves to pick up the back heel as we move forward. Five, six, seven, eight, step one, two. From here, we're going to step out on the right foot, just to slightly corner. So we're gonna keep the turnout that's happening right now. The palm is gonna come down and the left foot's gonna stay on the floor. Three. We're gonna try to mimic this level. We're just gonna be looking into our palm and following with our head. Three, we're gonna come up and to lift the left foot and to then drop it down to first position, four. Nice and low. And we wanna be quite a bit contracted in the belly here. We're gonna roll the palm of the right hand in and around twice as it lifts up and up. And we want it to be almost inflating our chest as we stand as we grow. So we're here, we're nice and low. We're gonna come up five, six, and then we're gonna deflate everything as we hit two times down hard with our left hand. Seven, eight. As we're hitting nice low and low, we're finding a juicy contraction in the right side of our body while we progressively bring our left hand to the small of our back, fingers pointing down. We almost want to feel like an old person with a cane. That is very much the feeling. So we're growing tall and growing up, and then we're falling into more of that almost elderly stance, down and down. Yes, like life is getting heavy on us. There's still a nice extension of the neck. Watch it. We don't tuck our chin into our chest. Because this combo doesn't move a whole ton, and because it is a little bit more about movement than, say, crazy legs, crazy jumps, or anything like that, we want to make sure we're filling that space with our chest, with our hips, with all of the elements of our body, with our extremities, and we want to make sure we're playing with texture quite a bit. So we want to make sure we're looking up, up, and finding that breath, and then slamming it down nice and contracted, and so changing that texture up. From here, we're going to change it again. We're going to find a really beautiful breath underneath our armpits as we away. So trying to isolate just the arms, we're keeping this contraction. One, two, three, four. Then we're going to find a slight movement as our right arm whips underneath us to come underneath our ribs and to change our stance slightly, now contracted over the left side of our body. One, seven, eight. We'll be one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. As you can see, that five kind of initiates a pull to the left, but the arms somewhat stay the same in their movement quality. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. For the one, two, three, four, the arms are just going to continue out, and we're going to whip our head on the one. And we almost want the eyes to be scanning that left arm all the way over to the right and into the palm. So we have seven, eight. You're going to be one, two, three, four, pull it, five, six, seven, eight, whip it, one, two, three, four. From here, you're going to take four steps, starting with the left foot. You're going to slowly bring the hands in closer to the body, so dragging with the elbows, keeping them tight, and finding more strength in the palms as we step left, right, left, right. Again, if you don't have a ton of space, try to step a little bit underneath yourself so that you're not truly moving to the left, more so moving on the spot, just making wider steps more so than anything. So as we release this head, one, two, three, four, we again want to be leading with the heels from this first position, five, six, seven, eight, and just finding more of a contraction here and a nice lowering of the hips. We're stepping out into like somewhat of a turned out second position. It doesn't have to be crazy turned out, but it also does not have to be parallel, just making sure our inner thighs are still firing. So let's go from the top. We went holding one, two, three, four, falling five, six, seven, eight. We hit one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. We breathe one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Head one, two, three, four. We look five, six, seven, eight. Mm-hmm. Let's hear just that much before we move on. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So as you can see, it's a little bit speedy. However, it's totally attainable. Watch that you're not holding too much tension in unnecessary areas, especially the neck and the head. When we enter this position, 1, 2, 3, 4, and take these steps. We don't want this to feel too crazy. We just want to have a nice, light, natural look into the hands. So don't overdo it with the shift of the head and try to release some tension in that neck. Maybe take the tongue off of the roof of your mouth. You'd be surprised what can happen. 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, we're going to keep the focus down to this right hand as the hand slap back. So we're going to take our hands, like Mean Girls thigh slap, onto the outside of our thighs as we jump back, trying to maintain this shape of the body over this like almost cliff edge and bring our legs back and closer together. So we went 6, 7, 8. We're gonna throw it back. 1, 2, head stays. We're gonna bring them even closer together just so they make it to a parallel hip width stance as we again slap the hands forward, but with breath this time. The right hand coming in front of the left hand coming in front of the body, the right hand coming out from the side. 3, 4. The head does change. We went 5, 6, 7, 8. The head is focusing still down where this right hand was left. 1, 2. And then we are going to shoot it up, forward, and out. 3, 4. From here, we're going to devil pay the right leg and right arm up and out towards the front. Now, the height of the leg does not matter. Feel free to go wild if you like to. Just maintaining that movement quality. So we're moving through with more fluid motion. We went 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to bring it up. 5, 6. It extends fully on 7. So watch you're not getting there until the last N of 7. 5, 6. Out, 7, bring it, and 8, and 1. So we don't want to hit until 1. We're finding a juicy contraction in the mid-body. We're bringing that left hand back to where it was in the beginning on that 7, 8. So still in that, like, almost like you're walking with a cane feeling. We want to have an ache in our back. That is the feeling that we're trying to emit with the positioning of the arm on the left side of the body. So we come up 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Notice the lift of the chest on that 8. That pull in, almost like with elasticity, and then a nice hit and a nice hold with the contraction in the mid-body. 1, we're going to hold. 2, we're not going to move. Hitting this position, we almost want to get our right elbow to our right knee or right thigh. So 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. We want to hold this position. We want to maintain the shape of the left side of our body as we open it up. So for 3, 4, we're just going to try to find somewhat of a rotation 3, 4 to open up further and further using our hip. So 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. 2, we move 3, 4, we go 5, 6, 7, 8. So all that's happening here, we're holding solid that 2. We're gonna open it up 3, 4. We're gonna step down right foot first, 5, 6. The hand just lays off of the leg into a more extended elbow. We then move it over to the left, follow with our head, and back to the right. That's 7, 8. From here, I'm not the greatest with counts at this part, so we're going to stick with lyrics. So I invite you to listen to this song quite a bit just to really embed it in your body. You have the time, so why not use it? So here we are, 7, 8, it says, every. So on every, we want to change that feeling again. So very sharp, sharp, and almost a little bit whippy. We want to then find like a melting through a thicker substance. So maybe we're moving through something like peanut butter or something even thicker, like wet cement. We want to be pulling up with the wrist down with the right fingers. The left hand comes back up to the low back. Our heels start to drive a bit forward as we find a contraction on the right side of our body. So we go every down and almost having the gaze past the wrist. Every, you're going to pull it back up and look away. So just back to the stance we were just in. 1, we're just bringing the head over to the left instead. As the head shifts back over to the right, the arm comes up, palm in towards the head, and inner elbow lifting up. This is on 1. You're going to look away as the left hand comes up to the side of the head. The head, not the face. We're not touching faces here today. So we're grabbing onto the back side of our left, the left side of our head, and we're going to throw it down into the right bicep as if we're like dabbing. Oh, I'm too old for dabbing, but it's fine. You're going to come down on no. We want to throw it so hard that the weight shifts off of that left foot and into the right. We can work our heel forward a bit so that we're not in a dangerous position with the knee. Also be flexing the left foot just so we don't have like that floppy foot situation happening. So again, we went 7, 8. You're going to come down every, you're going to come back to it. 1, I, no, oh. Yeah, so the timing, I think I was off a little bit that first time I said it, but this is catching both syllables of the word no. I know that no only has one, but the way he sings it is like no, to me at least. So we come down, 7, 8. Every one, I know, boom, ta ta. So all we're doing here is bringing this arm through, slicing the arms back as the left knee opens up. We're shifting the body. So the hips are quite forward so we can find this hinge. Then we are going to bring the arms through. So they're gonna reach back, still bladed. They're gonna curve in and up to shift the weight into that left foot onto the ball of the back leg. Yes, and not locking out, being aware that we still need a nice plie for the next part. So going back, maybe let's go to the devil pig position. You went 5, 6, 7, 8. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, hold 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Every one I know, boom, tap, tap, goes away. From here, you're gonna take the arms from this parallel position. So watch if they're parallel and they're just directly out from the shoulders. They're gonna keep extending onto the horizon. So feel that extra bit of reach through the body. Here, you're gonna slap them back. As you do, you're going to push weight into that back leg and you're just gonna do a slight jump with like the smallest attitude position in your left leg. You're gonna jump again. If you do not have a lot of space in your home, modify these jumps as you will. They do not need to be concrete. So from here, we push it back. From here, you're gonna step that left foot back and the arms are going to come to here. As you do, your right leg is going to come to somewhat of an attitude position, back attitude. From here, you're going to jump everything up towards the ceiling. So just taking the arms down and up, you're gonna cross the right arm closest to body and then throw it down as you just do a regular jump up to the ceiling, legs into a parallel position, into a hip width, and land heavy over the thighs into a contraction. So the last jump, after the attitude, we're just going, like we're collecting as much air as possible and slamming it down into the ground. From this position, we're gonna have a slow roll up. Slow, 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 slow. Again, at this part, we will be using lyrics and not counts, but we'll get back to that. So we went. Every one, I know, boom, tap, tap, goes away. 6 and 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I really want to see that nice, like, juicy hit. And then that feeling of pull, that expansion in the back to go dig into the belly to rise up, having the head be the last thing. Okay, so moving on to the last section. We just fell over our thighs. We're going to slowly roll up through each vertebrae, taking our time. 3, 4. We're going to bring the arms through the body with some breath under the armpits, but not too much. As we step the right heel out to the corner, we're going to come up and we're going to lead with the blade on top. So the right blade, we're creating almost this like square shape with the elbows and hands. You're going to bring it up and you're going to flick it twice or flex it twice. You could. So keep opening up those toes towards the corner. And you could. We're gonna stall here for a second. You're gonna find breath underneath. So this hand is gonna release. This one's going to stay the same. So left stays. Right hand from here is gonna find underneath and out to find the breath as we bring that left leg in without letting it leave the floor. So, and you could have it all. Yes. So we're going hit, tick, tick. So wanting to isolate just the hand, just the foot, everything else just shifts as it may. Find the breath, boom, and then a second one and down. Then we switch it over nice and soft. As we go to switch, we're gonna hit it right back, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's almost like we're visiting, we're not staying. So we visit to then change our mind to hit, boom, down, boom, up, up. And there's a slight bend in the elbows. We don't want to be extended too far here, but we're just basically pointing to our steps. Left, right, left, right. Still keeping a nice plie, just a little bit wider than parallel stance. So that is, and you could have it all, and a tap, 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 tap. That's 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, you're gonna dig the arms down, finding contraction and letting the palms push into our bellies to find even more space in the back. My M. From here, we're gonna release all of that as we rise up into a nice high releve. I'll move back so you can see. Finding breath in the arms and almost a peel away of the hands to rise up with the chest, up with the head, out with the arms, letting our extremities continue, continue, continue until the very last second. He says, tick, 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 my M on fire. We release. We're gonna scoop the hands out, just like in the jump with the right passing closest to the body. of continuing that reach, slamming it down on dirt, letting our fingers be very wide and strong, pointing in towards each other, letting the knees come in just slightly, heels out, into this turn in position. From here, we're gonna act as if we have super glue on our feet or in a really thick mud and we're trying to pull our feet out of it. So our focus is down beyond the two hands. We are going to peel left, right, left. And this is the one time I will say, sickling's all right, no worries. So from here, we're leading with the knife edge of our feet. Pull, pull, pull. From here, you're going to bring the knees out and in, make sure you're on the balls of your feet, and the hands will go out and in, tick, tick, very fast. So watch that your weight is always concentrated to the balls of your feet. From here, you're gonna go push, push. On the second push, you're gonna bring that left foot in, and you're gonna bring the right foot in, the left toes out, tick, tick. So if you're watching the feet closely, all that's happening is this one's gonna open, and this one's gonna close. So we're gonna come back to that first by moving the toes and moving the heel. You're going tick, tick, down. Make sure you're holding your core here so there's no wibble wobbles. Again, that was, and you could have it all, switch and a tup, 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 my empire of dirt, stick, 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 I will tup, tup, let you. So from this position, you're going breathe. So you're finding a little bit of almost like a circle rotation of your right hand around your left blade, let, then a bigger one to come up to place the palm upwards underneath the chest, and then the palm downwards with the hands meeting and a little lift with the chin. From here, we're going to release it on the word down. So we're releasing down, keeping that nice turnout down, but still trying to fight the down feeling with our hips with a lift in the chest, down. And you're going to bring the legs in together, leading with a little bit of a slap in the right hand, foom, foom. So outside of the thigh, inside of the thigh, and then the top of the thigh, and feeling like, again, that stickiness, like you're leaving spider webs behind or something, or Spider-Man here, to pull it up. And leading with the hips a little bit forward so that we're not sitting back. This is tap, tap, tap. You're gonna bring this hand to your head as the left hand falls down. Now into a fist. We're gonna punch ourselves lightly and gently in the head, or don't even make contact, and that's okay. It's gonna hit boom. So as we send the forehead back, or the base of the head back, we're gonna lift the chest to then sit the chest down, send our hips forward. We're actually gonna open up the thigh first, make. We're gonna find a nice juicy contraction in the right side of the body and close it and maintain this feeling with the upper body. So we're still gonna keep the shape of the head. We're just gonna move everything over to the left side. Yeah, this is on. I will make you. Watch it, it's very syncopated to his voice. So be careful you're not rushing those last two. I will make you. And from here, you're going to jump the feet out. Again, we want to be on the balls of the feet. We're going to jump out to the right. Again, if you have to cut under yourself, that's fine too. You're going to jump out to the right, out and out and. So thinking knees out, heels in, and then switching. Maintaining the lowness of the body, maintaining the shape of the head so that it's not too awkward. We want to find interesting shapes to make sure that we're challenging our bodies. So we want to make you. We want to bring our hands just outside of our chest. They're going to come out, in, as we find lift, contract. So we're here. Tuck, 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 tuck. We want to be very grounded. We want to almost be slamming into the floor. Sorry to your parents and family members if we're making a little bit of a racket, but it might be necessary for this one thing. So we have, I will make you. We go tuck, 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 tuck. Yeah, so hitting hard into that jump. So we're hitting to the ground. Yeah, be careful of your body. So tick, 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 tick from here. From the second one, we're gonna jump back right, left as our arms rotate up and around and hit out. So all you're doing is lifting the right foot first, landing it down, and then landing on the left heel with an extended leg. From here, we're going to rotate this hand down again in another circle to lift it up. We're just dragging the right foot in, it's truly not leaving the floor, and moving from our heel into the ball of the foot into a forced arch with our left leg. So we went tap, tap, you're gonna rotate, zoom, lift. And we're nice and lifted, similar to the beginning when we went boom, boom, but now we're in a fist, and we're gonna lower it down heavy without lowering down that heel. So we're gonna find all this lift, And we're just going to take it away, throwing it down. From here, you're going to bring that elbow back, going to turn back into a blade, and we're going to shove the heel into the floor as we open up to start our journey back to the front. And we're just repeating from the beginning. So after we went, I will make you hurt. Top, 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 da, 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 da. And move. I'll give you the last few steps and then we'll go back over it 1 million times. Ta, ta, or maybe not a million because you have a rewind button. We have boom, boom. We're going to step forward just like the beginning. Tick, tick. So we're heading back to those two steps with the left blade leading with the right heel leading. We have tick, tick. Then we're going to have three that grow, all on the right foot, all with the left hand leading, and they're just going to grow, and we want them to feel desperate, desperate, and desperate, like we're reaching for something. That's boom, boom, boom. So it's going to keep growing. We're just going to be rocking back and forth. Pull, pull, pull. So a nice heavier step into the ball of the right foot, and a light step on the back of the left, so that we can have that feeling of pull and resistance. At the very last moment there, so we've one, two, and three, there's going to be a throw. It can be over your left shoulder, right shoulder, whatever. It's basically your body physically taking you away from whatever you were reaching for. So if you are physically going to do it yourself, you can. If you want to, ta, 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 and just whip it back, leading with a certain point of the body, feel free to play with that a bit. Different things you could do are turns over the shoulder, maybe a jump back, or potentially leading with a certain position of the body, like the base of the skull, like an elbow, like a hip, that's going to pull you backwards. So whatever you do on that last count, make sure it's pulling you back and leading you into your improv. So let's go from the top, nice and slow. Then let's do the whole dang thing, and that is in your hands. So here we go. We hold proud. One, two, three, four. Come down, five, six, seven, eight. We go one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, step five, six, seven, eight. Slap one, two, slap three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And one, hold two, three, four, down five, six, shift seven, eight. Every one, I know, bam, tap, tap, goes away. And a six, and a seven, eight. One, two, three, four, and you could have it all. Ta 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 ta, my empire of dirt. Stick, stick, stick out in ta ta, let you and down. Slap, slap up, I will out in and out in, out in ta ta, up and I could start again. Ta ta, one, two, three, and whoop. Some sort of throw. So that is the whole thing from the top. If you need any assistance with anything, feel free to comment and potentially I can get back to you before the deadline. And if you're not even going to be entering the contest, that is not a problem. If your mom wants to try this combo, your dad, your brother, your sister, whoever, please feel free to let them join you. Why not have some fun with it? Find some creativity with it. Again, this isn't a contest of who does it best. It is truly a random draw. So have fun with it, and let's try it from the top.
I am still right here.
One, two, and four, five, six, seven.
What have I become?
One, five, six, seven, eight, pop.
My sweetest friend.
And one, two, seven, eight.
Everyone I know.
Slap, tap, tap.
Goes away.
And a six, seven, eight, one.
And tap, tap. You could have it all.
Cues. Now I will do it again without anything, without my voice talking over the music, so that you can just see some interpretation and my version of it. Now, not to copy, but of course to maybe take inspiration from, or maybe say, that is not for me, I'm gonna do it this way, and that's totally cool. So one more time, and it's all up to you. Have fun. Really excited to take part in this. I can't wait to take the other teachers' classes, and
farewell for now. Bye.
I am still right here. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all. My empire of dirt. I will let you down. I will make you hurt. If I could.